Good afternoon. Welcome to our training today. My name is Edward. I'm the assistant from the office manager of the Palace International Hotel. Before we start the training, I would like to ask you a few questions. What's your name?
My name is Jill.
Jill, it's nice to meet you. How are you today?
I'm good.
Okay. So, do you have any working experience before you join our hotel?
I just graduated from my university, but I have one internship before.
So which university did you go?
Palace University.
Palace. So so I assume the hotel you do the internship is really good. Which one?
Hilton.
Hilton KL. Okay, so have you ever worked in a front office before?
No, I spent 3 months in F&B department.
Okay, so let's start our training for today. For the task of this training is to show you how to overcome some negative comments for hotel. A negative comments from the guests will be very jeopardize our hotel image, and we should learn how to avoid the occurrence of the negative comments. Here is the lesson plan for today. You know the task already, and at the end of the session, you should be able to learn how to avoid the happens of the negative comments. And when you work, I will also show you how to handle guests during your service, and you will know how to minimize the possibility that will be the negative comments. So we will spend most of the time in this training and go through some actual negative comments from our guests. And I will ask you some questions after the training. And let's hope that we will finish the training within 20 minutes. So let's go through some actual negative comments of our guests. So the purpose of we having this training about the negative comments is because recently, over the past few months, our front office department has received a lot of bad reviews, which is under our normally average points. And our management is not very satisfied with the service we are providing to our guests. That's why we are having the training of this one today. So let's see some actual guest comments. First guest, he said upon his check-in, he informed our front office desk staff to ensure that his wife's name is keyed in the room and keyed in the hotel system, but eventually he found out her name was not in the room. We will talk about the solution later, and let's just go through the comments first. Guest 2, he informed the operator, which is also the front office staff, that he will be at two different places and at two different times, and assuming someone is coming to look for him. So he was not able to reach the visitors himself. That's why we need to transfer the message to his visitor. And because of our negligence, we forgot the specific request of this guest. And he found out that his friend is not able to call him because our staff didn't remember the request properly. Guest 3, he was told that our staff said the hotel will upgrade him to the deluxe room, but when he is leaving the hotel, he found out he was charged the deluxe room rate. Guest 4, he requested for the late checkout at 3 p.m. upon arrival, which means when he checked in, he had already informed us that he will be checked out on 3 p.m. But during on the day that he was leaving the hotel, our staff keep calling him and asking when he will be leaving after the normal checkout time. So he is wondering why our staff is not remembering the request of his So let's go back to our first guest. So if you are meeting the situation like this, how would you do, or you will handle the guest to minimize the this negative comments with happen?
I'm not sure.
Alright, so if you're not sure, so let's say because every hotel have a very strict security rules. Normally from the local department, like a police office, they will inform us that the visitor is not allowed to entering the property without permission of the owner or the guest. So if our staff, let's say our staff didn't put this guest's wife's name into the system, that means his wife is not able to go inside the room with his husband, to stay in with his husband. So this guest are supposed to have the room, share the room with her, his wife, but because our staff forgot to put the name into the system, that makes unsatisfaction of the guest, and of course the negative comments will show up. So the thing is, once the guest is checking and making the request like this, if the time allows, you just do it immediately after he requests. Maybe you can just put two names under the room, so this will never happen. Guest two. He said he told our staff that he will be at two different locations during two different times. So that means a friend is coming to visit, but he needs us to transfer the message to his visitor. So this negative comments show up because our staff mistake the time and the location, and the lucky thing is the thing is not really important, which the visitor approaching this guest is only for a leisure, a talk or something. But let's assume that if the matter is really important, if it's a business decision had to make, and our staff came to mix up the time and the location, and the result is the visitor is not able to approach the guest, and they had to reschedule, and maybe this will be some bad consequences, not only to the hotel but also to our guests. So make sure that you remember all the specific requests from the guest. Our third guest. Okay, so this one is always happen not only in our hotel, also the others. So once you promise that you are giving your guest some benefits, like upgrading him to the higher level of rooms, a better room, he should not be charged to the price of this kind of room. Let's say this guy only checking for a superior, and our staff promised to give him a tailored suite, just saying. And so when he is leaving, we only charge him for the superior, because that's what we promised to the guest. Once we didn't deliver what we said to him, he will be unsatisfied, and the bad comments is coming, which is not good to our hotel. Guess what? Alright, this is also common in our hotel. A guest informed you during the check-in he will be later than the normal checkout time, because the normal checkout time is around 12 p.m. Right? So, but he requests for late checkout, which is 3 p.m. and which is not free. We will charge him for the late checkout half day, but our staff intentionally calling him during the checkout time because they are not aware which this guest is requesting for the late checkout. So that means it's improper when our front office changing the shift, maybe in the morning and the afternoon, the staff is different, they will not aware some of the requests of the guests. That means it's our mistake that we didn't change all the errands from one shift to another shift. When we are changing the shift, the new shift staff should be able to understand everything happens in the morning in the last shift and be aware of all the requests from all the guests, which will be easier to avoid this situation to happen. Okay, see some solutions. This is only the general solutions of the situation like this. So when we are working in the front office, a staff should always prepare a pen and a note paper, which you just put beside you on the table. And assuming that a guest is making a request, but you have a long queue afterwards, you don't have the time to key in them into our system on time. You can just write down on the paper, and after you dealing with all the guests, you've got the time available. You can just follow your paper, follow what you write, you put them into the system, and just under the guest name and all the new shift staff will see the request, and that will be avoid the mistake will be happen. So for the next one, if the time allows, key the information into the system immediately. That means if you only have one guest checking and he's making some really important request for him, maybe to him not important to us, but we still need to treat it very serious and just put them into your opera system if the time allows. Understand specifically what your guest is requesting. Like the guest 2, he's making maybe choose the stuff maybe a little bit complicated, and so if you are not understanding what the guest is requesting, never be ashamed to ask them again. You need to make sure that you understand the request, that in case that you need to transfer some message to other people. So be smart and try to avoid the possible which will occur a negative comments which on the four negative comments from the guests before I have mentioned. Each situation you need to handle them very smart. You need to maybe remember, maybe you need to take a note. Everything is based on the real situation. You need to be very smart to know what you should do to avoid this comment. So be familiar with what you are doing, and the optimized make best use of the front office system, which is Opera. In our hotel, we use Opera as our front office system. In each guest account, you will have a remark column which you can put all the requests from the guest inside. We will not go through the system today because it's not the purpose of the training today. And for the next training, we will see that one. So follow your SOP strictly, because you are working in a 5-star hotel. You have everything you are doing, you have a standard operation procedure. So you just follow them to minimize the possibility that you will make a mistake. Okay, so that will be all for our situations. Let's move forward to our next part. Okay, the next part, Q&A. Before I ask you questions, do you have any questions for me?
No questions.
Okay, so I have prepared two questions for you to examine how you learn from this training. The first question is really easy. Explain why is it important for a hotel to avoid negative comments.
Some guests booking the hotel maybe they will check the other guests' comments. If there are so many negative comments, maybe the guests will not book our hotel.
Yes, correct. The negative comments will always show in our website. Will always show the website of our cooperating travel agent website. So that's true that all the guests will always check the reviews before they book the room. So many negative comments will be jeopardizing our hotel image, and nobody will choose us. side is really important for us to avoid the negative comments. The second question is, should we or should the hotel delete some negative comments from a guest? Okay, so it has been done before by some other hotels. They delete some bad comments from the guests in case to avoid the bad effect of the comments. But it's not a good behavior because that is the action to hide the truth from what we are facing in the service problems. For our hotel, the manager always believes that the problems are the opportunities which didn't present themselves. We can always convert the problems into a chance, which will help us to benefit more. So never try to delete or hide the truth from what had already happened. So just find the problem and solve them. Like what I showed before, we can learn how to handle the guests and we can minimize the risk which will lead a bad comments. It's all about us, how we deliver our service. So that would be all for the question and answers. And before we finish this training, what do you think of this training? Is it helpful?
Yeah, today I learned so many knowledge. I think it's really helpful and useful for my job. I
think
in some details I need to practice more, and maybe after practice I can be better.
Okay. Throughout the training process, I can see that you pay a lot of attention when I was explaining the situation to you. The only thing you are lack of is the experience since you just graduated from the school. You will be put in the field in the future and you will learn how to solve the problems when you are facing them. So that will be all for our training today. And for today's training, we learned how to avoid negative comments and when negative comments shows up, how to deal with the comments and how to solve the problems. And for the next training arrangement is on the next week, same day next week, 31st of October, and the venue will be in Crystal One. Time is from 9:30 to 10:30, and the task is related to our training today. I will teach you how to utilize your system wisely, how to use your remark column wisely to avoid the negative comments. Okay, that will be all for the training. Thank you for listening and have a nice day.